Hey guys, welcome to WP Xbox. This is Ashish, and today we have Lumia 620 with us for review, and we're going to review it with my experience of 20 days with Lumia 620, and I've done a lot of testing along with it to, you know, find out how good the phone is. So we'll break it into different sections so you get to know each and everything quite clear. So the first thing will be design factors. You know, anybody holding this phone, you know, you feel very comfortable because it is just of the right size. You don't feel any problem, you know, if the phone is big or small or something like that. And the curves and the smoothness the phone has, make sure it gives you a very strong grip. There's no problem at all with that. But the case is pretty solid. It's not a plastic case, so the kind of grip you will get is very, very neat. Now, another thing about look and feel you should know about is it's a dual shot case, which means it is made up of two colors. Right now it's white, so you might not be able to notice a lot, but it's actually cream and a different off-white color mixed with two. Now, if you take a combination of, you know, the green and the yellow one, you will actually find difference. So when you actually take out your phone, people glance at your phone, they'll feel like, you know, it's made up of multiple colors. So, you know, that's kind of different when you compare it with any other Lumia phone or any other competition phone. This is what you should know about look and feel. Let's take up the next factor, which we'll call it as screen and display. Lumia 620, now this is a 3.8-inch screen, which is almost like a 4-inch screen with Lumia 520 will have, but the phone looks obviously smaller because of the currents and all. But screen is very smooth. There's no problem you will face, you know, while scrolling it. It's not like a super AMOLED screen, but it's more like a plastic which is hardened, but the smoothness is still retained. So I cannot get a super AMOLED screen on a 15K range, but the quality of screen doesn't disappoint you at all. Even I've played games with it and there's not much of a problem with that. The second thing is display. Now, display is kind of disappointing with me because this is the, you know, the maximum brightness I get. I was expecting a bit more. Now, the problem is the colors are not vivid. You know, the colors is not that great like you have seen in Lumia 820. There's another problem is the display of the color changes when you actually change your angle. So this goes from blue to purple. So when you're watching a video or a movie, the colors will change from depending from what angle you are going to watch. So that's kind of thing you should actually know. So that was the display, design factor, screen and display part. We'll move on to the next part, which we'll call it as photographies, where we'll cover the camera, photos, video quality and recorded video quality and all those stuff. Stay tuned.
Okay, so what we're looking at is desktop mode, so don't get you know, surprised. So I wanted to show you a couple of pictures which I've taken on Lumia 620. So this is the daylight photograph with and without flash. This is without flash, this is with flash. It's not a complete daylight, but yeah, you can understand, you know, a lot of light is there, not completely dark either. So the quality looks pretty okay. Let's take a look at the low light photograph, which is pretty disappointing. So this is with low light, so you cannot actually figure out the stuff properly. Then let's take a look at the macro photograph. This was really impressive for me because the kind of detail it was able to, you know, withhold with it was pretty nice. So I can actually figure out, you know, the kind of zoom level I am in. So even if I zoom it a bit better, although it gets a little blurry, but you can see the smaller details have been picked up. So that's something really nice. Then let's take a look at the motion photographs. This is something which I've taken in motion. My son riding on a bicycle. So now it's going to be a little blurry, but the quality is good. Even though this has been taken on a car, and this is complete daylight, so you can get an idea of complete daylight photograph also. Now let's take a look at this backlit. Now since Lumia 620 is not a very good low light camera, so you know, this is the kind of, you might have to fiddle around with the settings. So you can see this is without backlit setting, and this is with backlit setting. Light coming from behind. There's a lot of light that is coming from behind, so you can understand. You know, I've taken it from with a backlight setting, and the picture quality improved. This is without backlight. So overall, the picture quality of, you know, Lumia 620 is pretty okay. There's no problem in that. But the low light photograph is not good at all. But daylight photographs where ample of light is there, there's no problem in that.
Now we're going to take a look at a different section, which I'll say it, Lumia 620 video recording, which I did on, you know, while I was moving in the car and I was, taking a look at the video and all those stuff. So let's take a look. So, you know, these are just a couple of videos which you'll be able to see, or you're actually viewing it. So the videos, I find the quality was pretty good. It does a 720p recording. There is no 1080p recording here. So that's the kind of video recording you will see. We can take a look at, like, this is my son. I asked him to just cycle and run towards me to find out, you know, stabilization. And then I also, you know, tried it with a video which was running on my 920. This is something which you can see, you know, the quality of video which you can see while at the dark, you know, when it is very dark. So if you still have, you know, better lights around, it will work out very fine. But if there's a lot of darkness and all, the video quality might not come out. So, you know, this is with light and that was without light, so you can see the obvious difference. These are the two videos which I took during the, you know, while moving the car. So, you know, there's not much of optical image stabilization, you know, after Lumia 920, everybody expects that. But, you know, that thing is not there, but it is okay. I mean, I cannot expect a very good, you know, stable video from this kind of device, but it was still okay. There's no problem in that. You can see the fields and the cars and trucks moving around, and you can notice the audio quality also. So, also that's kind of a video you can expect to get from Lumia 620. Lumia 620 comes with a very nice speaker which is positioned here. So make sure you don't listen to audio when putting your phone down. Instead, you can just keep it like this. And the best way will be to use your headphones, you know, so that nobody else gets disturbed. And you get to use the equalizer and the Dolby, you know, sound which comes with Lumia 620. So the next video I'll put in will, you know, come with a bit of a sample of audio which you can actually listen and see how it goes. So how does a video look like when you play it on Lumia 620? So I just ran a sample video, and you can actually hear the quality of audio also if I put it in. So, you know, this is the kind of video you can see. But like I said before, as the angle changes, the color changes, and that's kind of disappointing. But yeah, if you like to take a look at it straight, there's no problem on that.
Let's talk about the battery life now. It's a small phone, 3.8 screen phone, which has a battery power of 1350 mAh. And since it, you know, it's a low resource phone or less hungry phone, your battery is going to last from almost 16 hours for 12, 16 hours. But if you go on 3G, it cannot last beyond 12 hours. So that's the kind of battery life you can get. The voice quality and all was fine. There's no problem in that. So even if you talk for a longer period, the battery will last a little bit lesser, but you won't be disappointed with the battery life. Now there are, you know, certain factors which you should know, like when you play a lot of games, the battery consumes gets very fast. And if you talk a lot, I mean a lot, like for 2-3 hours, the battery will get consumed a lot. And if you are roaming, like when I was in roaming, it didn't last more than 10 hours or 8 hours because, you know, the signals go on and off all the time. I was there on train for 24 hours. So, you know, all your battery life depends on how do you use it. But on an average or for a general use, the battery is going to easily last for almost, like, you know, 16 hours or to 14 hours, something like that. Don't expect anything more than that. Not all the games are going to run on Lumia 620 because it's you know, low memory or the lesser memory part. But, you know, games can be optimized for this. For example, if you go to games, and you know these are all the games which run on Lumia 620. Next is the video I will put in, or I will link to, where you can actually go. Now Drift Mania Champion uses a Unity 3D engine which is updated, and now it works on Lumia 620. So the games has to, you know, get optimized to work. Next video will show you a bit of game on Lumia 620, and you can follow the link and go to watch the video. Now one thing you should know about Lumia 620 is the exchangeable back shell. So you know, this can be actually replaced with a different one. So if you don't like white, you can bring in a different color and put it in, and the phone changes. Something similar to Lumia 620, you know, design factor. Sorry, the 820 design factor. So you know, there's something you should know, and the back shell quality is pretty good. You know, you can press it like very, very hard, and you know, not look at my hand, look at the case. You know, if you press it really, really hard, nothing actually happens to the case. So it's a very strong quality. If you have seen the Lumia 520-620 initial thought video, you might have seen the Lumia 520 shell is, you know, it's like you can fold it like paper or something like that. So it comes with a very strong case. The quality is good. That's the reason it gives you a very strong grip also. And you can change it to a color you want. So that's the kind of back shell you're looking for, which is definitely a, you know, advantage to the Lumia 620. Okay, so a lot of people told me that I don't talk about much about the OS when I compare to the phone. The reason is it's all same, more or less, plus or minus here. So there's nothing to be talked about specifically. If you have known Windows Phone, or if you know Windows Phone, it's all the same experience. But let me give you a quick preview, you know, what kind of phone it is. So this is the home screen where there are tiles, the same for Windows Phone. These are all your applications, and applications which you can expect is you have Office, WhatsApp works on that, then you have music, videos, and games, and you have social networking stuff. Foursquare is there, and you know, again, Nokia exclusive apps like the Here Maps, Drive, CityLens, and all stuff is there, so you can use it. Then you have Office inbuilt, you have OneNote, and you have Skype and WhatsApp working, Twitter is working. So you know, there's a kind of OS, and it comes with IE, you know, IE 10. It has some basic stuff. We can switch tabs, recent, favorite, window start, find on page, and all those stuff. So you know, that's a very brief about the OS. It's very stable. There's no problem with the performance, so you don't have to worry much about that. The apps has to be optimized since it's a low-end phone. So they need to be optimized. If you are feeling a bit laggy about any of the apps, probably you can send out a feedback in reviews and all, and probably the developers can look. But some of the apps which are already optimized, like, you know, the WhatsApp is optimized, works pretty nicely, and the Skype app works just fine. So there's no problem on all those stuff. So that was Lumia 620 from my side. It's a great phone in 15,000. If you're looking for, you know, it's a different form factor, and you know, the quality is there. You know, the quality and the price factor has come to a stage where, you know, they just fit together very fine. So if you're looking for that kind of phone, Lumia 620 is a great deal for you. So go and buy it. Thanks.